And we're here at the Catalina Jazz Club talking to Skip Martin from Cool the Gang and Jon Barnes. Now, you're going to be playing tonight with Arturo Sandoval. Tell me what that's like and how this all happened.
Well, Arturo is such a legend and an icon in music in general, and such a wonderful guy that it's such an honor to play with a cat who's played with all the super bad cats in jazz music. And Arturo invited us out because we had played at the festival, and I'm telling you, it's wonderful how much fun we had with him and how much he embraced the music and the instruments.
Now, you both have been influenced by people like Dizzy Gillespie, Louis Armstrong. We all grew up with those
people. Arturo Sandoval, Miles Davis.
Wynton Marsalis. Tell me how that has influenced your life, why it's important to have a mentor when you're getting into music or whatever industry.
Well, you know, first of all, let me tell you, I used to hate classical music until Wynton Marsalis came on the scene. And so once I heard him play something like...
Now, is that your favorite song?
Now it is.
Tell me about how you got into the whole jazz scene and just how you ended up. You obviously had a couple of bands before Cool and the Gang. There's always that little story. Tell me about that first gig, and did you ever think you'd be going to Europe with a decarbonized trumpet?
I didn't think I'd be going to Europe. I didn't know about going anywhere playing it, but I knew I was going to lay some ground in humanity by playing and being myself playing music. So I started at a very early age, about 7. And I came out of Monterey in Sacramento, California, and I was doing jazz festivals. My first jazz festivals were with my band in high school, and my first professional band, I started playing at 15 as a pro, and I never looked back. I just kept on doing what I do, and I've enjoyed it, you know, the whole time. And my influences were guys like Art Farmer and Arturo Sandoval and Miles Davis. And believe it or not, Donald Byrd, God bless his soul. And I loved how they made it sing, how they made the horns sing. So these are all great, and Jon Barnes, these guys are all great trumpet players. I'm neither of those. I just sing through the trumpet. So I enjoy what I'm doing.
Good people are always shy about their talent. Jon here is very talented. He's got a lot going on. Tell me what your big influence was. And how young were you when you said, I can do that or I want to do that?
Well, long time ago, once upon a time, I walked into a room and everyone was playing this trumpet, trying to, and you know what, they were doing this, and they couldn't play it. So I said, listen, let me try. They said, no, it was a whole room full of adults. I think I was 8, and I said, let me try. And after everyone finished blowing their brains out, doing it wrong, I finally said, can I try now? And they let me. I took a big breath, another big breath. They all looked at me like, wow, how did you do that? Little teeny kid, play that trumpet. And I never stopped ever since. Started playing at church, grannies go, play your horn for the Lord, boy. I was like, making all sorts of noise up in there, you know? And the point is, my mom would have Louis Armstrong records, Clifford Brown records, Lee Morgan records. She would have Dizzy Gillespie records, Charlie Parker records. And that heritage of music, I mean, Dave Brubeck records. I mean, my mom was hip. I had no idea. So I took them. I was like, these are not my records. So my influence is my mom.
Great.
All right. And she just laid it all down for me.
And your family, too.
Same thing. My grandfather was a minister. He gave me my first trumpet. And I was playing trumpet in the choir.
Wow.
Until one day my grandfather turned around and they were playing something. They fill my cup, let it overflow. Grandfather turned around and said, boy, don't you ever play that devil's music in here.
All right. Hey, thanks for talking to us. Have fun tonight.
Look,